Good morning, praise the Lord. Today, June 26th, we'll talk about a lying pen. Jeremiah 8:8 says, how can you say we are wise, for we have the law of the Lord, when actually the lying pen of the scribes has handled it falsely? Hope you are able to understand what I want to say, what the prophet wants to say. How can you say we are wise, for we have the law of the Lord, when actually the lying pen of the scribes has handled it falsely? The prophet Jeremiah is exposing the false prophets who were misleading the people with their lying pens. Modern days, it's a fake audio or video. Truth was interpreted in such a way that it becomes a lie. The blame is on the lying pen that was used by leaders of the nation of Israel. The people thought that they were wise concerning the law of the Lord, but the scribe, the prophet, the priest had misinterpreted and made people believe lies. The false prophets who claimed to be writing and speaking in the name of the Lord deceived the kingdom of Judah. They were men whose personal lives were godless, whose hearts were covetous, and whose remedies for the problems of the nation were useless. Their ministry was popular because they majored on the superficial and marketed whatever good news the people wanted to hear. Jeremiah pictured these men as deceitful physicians, empty wind dispensers of chaff, ruthless, selfish shepherds, and infected people spreading disease. All these references are in Jeremiah only, book of Jeremiah. God had not sent these so-called prophets, nor did they receive their messages from God. Please stop for a few seconds and rethink of what Jeremiah is trying to tell us. Don't we have such leaders now? They are ruining the church with their false teachings and lying pens. Please be aware of them. What happens to the Lord's people largely depends on the leaders they follow. Worldly leaders attract and produce worldly people, but you pay a price to follow spiritual leadership. It's much easier to drift with the current and go along with the crowd. Jeremiah had very few friends or disciples because his message wasn't popular. The popular preachers are misinterpreting and twisting the truth of the scripture and making people to be attracted to the lies that they preach and write. The false prophets of the Old Testament times and the false prophets of these days know how to suit the taste of the multitude, and their prophecy smooths things. We notice it all the time. If you are under the influence of these lying pens and lips, please listen to the facts that I am putting forward, and then the choice is yours. The lies distort the facts and rules regarding our behavior in our daily lives. They deceive you and lead you in the wrong path. They create doubts and reduce your faith. They distract you from your spiritual path by putting forth irrelevant information and non-essentials as priority. They disturb our peace, moral norms, rules and regulations. Lying pens are specially for those who want to follow Christ and do His will. They are always having these problems. Lies cannot save, but only bring death. Please be careful. Let's pray. Lord, thank you for telling us about these lying pens of the scribes and priests. Please, Lord, please help us to be aware of this. In Jesus' precious name I ask. Amen. God bless you.